those who become are those who never settle. They know that there is always a better and greater version.
Believers, in times of adversity, remember to anchor your faith in God's unwavering love and promises. Trust in His divine plan and find strength in His presence. May this message serve as a source of encouragement and reaffirm your unshakable relationship with Him. Remain blessed as you listen.
The law of productivity. These are the laws that govern advancement. The law of productivity. Proverbs chapter 18, please, and verse 16. The law of productivity. It says the gift of a man. Proverbs 18 and verse 16. The gift of a man maketh room for him and bringeth him before great men. So your gift is like an usher. You know how you come into a place and they say, let me see your invitation. Oh, you're invited this way. Is your gift that is responsible for giving you space. To have an illusion that there is a space waiting for you is just sociological comfort. There is no space anywhere waiting for you. You create that space. Are we together?
Yes.
The gift of a man. The gift of a man. I was just celebrating and commending your pastor for the profound, his profound understanding in the area of faith, in the area of family life. I mean, it's uncanny, his perspectives. It's true. It's true. I think you should clap. How many lives, how many destinies, how many homes, how many people he has given answers and explanation and perspectives. The gift of a man. Nobody is going to keep clapping for you indefinitely for nothing. People love you, but they love themselves, they love their future. So to have this belief that people will indefinitely keep clapping, no. You must have something of substance that gives you space in destiny. I made up my mind as a covenant with my own life and destiny that everywhere God has granted me a gift and an ability, I will sharpen it in a way that it will be impossible for a generation to ignore you. Not for self-aggrandizement, but that these are principles that lift you to a position where you can represent the purposes of God. Please challenge the spirit of laziness in your life. Some of you, without developing your gift, people have started commenting on it. Imagine what happens when you develop it. I hope you still like me. Please, listen to me. Nobody goes to a mango tree without mango and just starts clapping and is happy. You look at the tree, you may stay a few minutes to get shade and move. But once it is time for mango, as it starts coming out, the fruit is calling you. The mango does not want followers. The mango is not looking for followers, but it is too gifted to be ignored. The mango does not go around calling for followers. It just keeps building the mango. And because hunger is something you cannot resist, you may ignore it for a while, but one day, when the sun scorches you and you stand and watch this mango. Trees don't call men, they only produce fruits. And men have to swallow their pride. Have you seen the skills that people employ to climb trees? All because they are looking for... I once saw a video of, I think they were trying to, this palm, I think the one they climbed with as though they are climbing a ladder. I said, you need all this skill to reach that tree. Be gifted and watch how people will inconvenience themselves with joy to come and place a demand on the grace of God upon your life. When people give excuses of time, excuses of comfort, it's because your gift is not notable enough. I assure you, ask the herbalist. A politician, respectfully speaking, will come with his own dignity and meet a man in a tattered room and not ask whether there is AC and not ask whether the man can speak English. The man says, turn behind and move backward. And he says, yes, sir. Because he knows that my political career is at the mercy of that. May you be so gifted in the name of Jesus. May your gift be so refined that it will be impossible for a generation to ignore you. Believe what I share with you. There are people in this country who cannot go out of a job for 1 month. Believe me. Believe me. In as much as we are saying there is no job, there are companies that if some of their people cough, they will buy a pharmacy, not a drug. Make up your mind that you will be so gifted. If it's a ministry, discern the dimensions of God's grace that he has put and work it out, place your life upon it. Apostle, God has called me to be a prophet. Like who? Everything you prophesy is wrong. The world will not place a demand on that kind of grace. Let's in the name of honesty. Are we together? Apostle, God has called me to be a kingdom financier. Let me know what you know about finances. Can you talk to kings? You are talking to your colleagues and you are happy about it. Your colleagues are not billionaires. Thank God for them. But your goal is to be able to mentor kings, that a nation will call you to hear the counsel of God upon your life. Make up your mind that you will not be small. Go back and refine your gifts. Apostle, do you know I can cook? Can the governor eat your food? Because you see, you have to serve kings to receive the rewards of kings. Am I challenging you? Let me tell you this. There is nothing that is of value that is not in sufficient demand in this life to bless you. If you are in every industry, there are people at the top. It's those who are at the top that enjoy the blessings. Make up, shake away mediocrity. When people are clapping for you, look at those clapping for you. If they are not kings, keep moving. Mark 1:37. And when they had found him, this was the story of Jesus. Jesus had finished healing, doing several things. He ran away to go and just rest and pray, and men would not let him rest. There was such a magnetic property. Let me tell you, being gifted carries a strange magnetic property. It's amazing the level of inconvenience people will go through with joy when you are gifted. I assure you, in today's world, most likely it's only your family that will love you whether you are valuable or not. God and your family members. They are enough to support you, but not enough to reward you. The vast majority of your reward will be in the hands of people who are in desperate need. They need people who are gifted. I made a vow with God that you will never make me twice to be blessed. No. Can you rise to that level of grace? Can you rise to that level of value? You are a CEO, your company. What solutions are you providing? Can I meet you once and be addicted to you because of the power of the value that you carry? Now, people give me all kinds of gifts and people paint me, and sometimes when I see the photo they give, I say, you mean this is me? You didn't see it? You know, of course, I love what they did, but You say, oh, no, no, come on, please. Are we together? And yet there are a few that I look at and I'm like, you do this? You say, yes, sir. What do you do? You say, once in a while, I just do it. And I'm saying, my goodness, once in a while, I would pay 1,000 times for this. Nigerians, wake up. Believers, wake up. There is something you have that the world is looking for. And can I tell you, they will not come to you while you are growing. They will come to the refined version of you. If your pastor hides today and says he's not going to preach for 5 months, he's going to have to beg God in that retreat and say, God, release me to bless people, because they will not let him rest. Someone's home at least will be on fire enough for them to call him and say, sir, please wake up. I don't care whether you are having a retreat, in the name of Jesus, if it takes flying you to this place, oh, you need to see how men react to real value. Your desire of decades can come to you in a moment when you make up your mind to be truly valuable. These are the laws of advancement. You enter your Sabbath to the degree to which you are valuable. You rise to a point where competition is no longer a possibility. You never have planes crashing with themselves in the air. There is enough space there. Traffic is usually down. Listen to me. Listen to me. Do you know that as I'm standing here right now, I'm rounding up, as I'm standing here right now, no matter how I stretch, I can't see the island. No matter how I stretch, I can't see Abeokuta, Ogun State, because I'm on the ground. But a star can be shining here and I can call someone in another state. He can still see the same star because it is high to the sky. If you become that star from where you are, you don't have to be moving. Anywhere people look at you, was it not a star that was shining, the same star called the Magi, right to that place where Jesus was? Spiritually, I know that some of us here are in ministry and we came to just honor pastor and honor the conference. God is challenging us. There is a dimension of grace, spiritual illumination, value that can be brought. When you bring something, the table of greatness is still empty, but you don't sit down for nothing. You first present your gift, then you sit down. And life must vet that gift. There is a threshold level of competence and accuracy that grants you access to sit down. Make up your mind that you will take away shame and reproach from your life and your family. In the name of Jesus Christ.